So we got y equals to 4 tangent of pi x. Okay, so our fake amplitude is 4, so if your numbers on the t table again are not separated by 4 units, you've made a mistake. The period is pi divided by b. That's kind of weird. Well, don't worry about it. You've done it right. It's pi over b. If the pi's cancel out, you just get 1, then the period's 1. The phase shift, no plus or minus in a set of parentheses, so there is no phase shift. There is no plus or minus at, you know, constant at the end of this equation, so there is no vertical shift either. And we always count by 1/4 of the period. And the period for this graph is 1. So we're counting by 1/4. All right, let's set up our t-table.
Shall we?
So we set up our t-table. By once again starting at the phase shift and counting by 1/4 of the period. Okay, no pi's in there, but the pi is right there in the equation. We're going to take that x, plug it by pi first, then take the tangent of that value, and then finally multiply it by 4. So if we take 0 and plug it in, 0 times pi is, of course, 0. And the tangent of 0, remember, tangent is y over x, and at 0, that's what? Y is 0 and x is 1, so it's 0. At 1/4 pi, 1/4 for x, pi, so pi over 4. The tangent of pi over 4 is 1, and 1 times 4 is 4. 2 pi over 4, or 1/2. We don't have any other fractions in this problem to worry about. So this is 1/2 times pi. So 1/2 times pi is pi over 2. The tangent of pi over 2, y over x, you're dividing by 0, is undefined. Plug in 3 pi over 4. 3 pi over 4, well, you're plugging 3/4. 3 pi over 4, the tangent of 3 pi over 4 is negative 1, so we got negative 4. And then we're going to have 0 again when we plug in 1. So our graph, our x-axis, 0, 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, and 4/4, or simply 1. And we can go negative 1/4 as well. Draw your vertical axis, your y-axis, through where 0 is, and we got y values of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, at 0, we're at 0. At pi over 4, we're at 4. At 1/4, we have 4, excuse me. At 1/2, or 2 over 4, we have an undefined value, so that's going to be a vertical asymptote. At 3/4, we got the value of negative 4. And at 1, 4 over 4, we got 0 again. So again, we've got this sort of broken period. If you want sort of like a more complete, you know, smooth graph, not something with a break in the middle, you can continue the pattern. So 0 to the left of that, we get negative 4. And one more tick to the left of that, we have a vertical asymptote. So we've graphed 1/2 periods of tangent. And I'm out of time. So I'm Mr. True.
Bam!
Go do your homework. Thank you for watching. All right, let's do our second example. Y equals cotangent of x plus pi over 4 minus 1. Okay, for this cotangent graph, our fake amplitude is going to be 2. Our period, again, tangent and cotangent have a period of pi, not 2 pi. So the period of this graph is going to be pi divided by b. the value in front of the x. So it's going to be simply pi. The phase shift is c over b. And don't forget, the standard form of a trig function like this is a trig function, parentheses, bx minus c, parentheses, plus d. So the standard form will have a negative sign there, not a plus sign. So that sign change must have happened because c was negative. So the phase shift is going to be negative pi over 4. The vertical shift is your plus or minus, your constant at the end of your equation outside of the actual math function. So that's negative 1. So the vertical shift is negative 1 or down 1. And when we set up our t table, we count by a quarter of the period. Well, 1 quarter of pi is, well, pi over 4. So this is going to be a little bit close here. Let me move this over. Now, don't forget, your phase shift, your count, you always start your t-table with the phase shift, and you count by a quarter of the period. Well, since my phase shift is negative pi over 4, we're going to start with that, and then start counting by a quarter of the period. Now, when you make these sketches, when you make these sketches, make sure that your count by value, your phase shift, and your value of c all have matching denominators. That's going to keep the work inside the t-table a little bit easier to do mentally, since we're not doing these with the aid of a calculator. So negative pi over 4 plus pi over 4 is 0, and then pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, and 3 pi over 4. Remember, we only need 5 points to make our first period of a trig function off our t-table. And again, we're trying to graph this as easy as possible, so we're looking for the zeros, the ones, and the negative ones. So you plug in negative pi over 4 plus pi over 4 is 0, and the cotangent of 0 radians, remember cotangent is x over y, so that's going to be negative 1 over 0. Oh, okay, so the first value is going to be undefined. And then at 0, when you plug in 0 for this equation, we're going to add pi over 4. So the cotangent of pi over 4 is going to be 1. Times 2 is 2. And then minus 1, 2 minus 1 is going to be 1. We always do that vertical shift last. Pi over 4. Pi over 4 plus pi over 4 is 2 pi over 4, or pi over 2. The cotangent of pi over 2, x over y, is going to be 0 over 1, so it's going to be 0. Times 2 is 0, and then minus 1. And then at 2 pi over 4, 2 pi over 4 plus 1 pi over 4 is 3 pi over 4, and the cotangent of 1, 2, 3 pi over 4 is going to be negative 1, times 2 is negative 2, minus 1 is negative 3. And then at 3 pi over 4, 3 pi over 4 plus 1 pi over 4 is 4 pi over 4, or 1. So the cotangent of 1 pi, with the y value being 0 again, is going to once again be undefined. Okay, so now that we have our t-table set up, let's go ahead and set up the x-axis and find out where 0 is and place the y-axis there. So we got negative pi over 4, 0, pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, and 3 pi over 4. Find out where that 0 is, put the y-axis there. If you happen to skip over 0, just put it in between the negative and positive x values. And let's see what we got. We have a vertical asymptote at negative pi over 4. At 0, we got an x value, or a y value of 1, excuse me. At pi over 4, we're at negative 1. At 2 pi over 4, we're at negative 3. And at 3 pi over 4, we have vertical asymptote again. So here we have, for 2, cotangent of x plus pi over 4, minus 1, we have our first period. And then if your teacher's requiring you, like I am, for most of these questions, for you to graph more than one period, but usually two periods, just keep this pattern going along. You got negative 1/4, 0, 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, 4/4. And the point there would be, well, after the vertical asymptote, we had a y value of 1. And at the next tick mark, we're going to have a y value of 0, but I'm running out of space, so there is a period and a half. The range of this graph is going to be all real numbers, and the domain is going to be, well, let's just pick an asymptote. The domain is going to be all real numbers where x is not equal to 3 pi over 4, plus or minus n, where n is an integer, plus or minus n, the period, every period, you're going to have this vertical asymptote show up again. So the domain is all real numbers where x is not equal to 3 pi over 4, plus or minus n pi. I'm Mr. True. That's your last example. Bam! Go do your homework.